The Ministry of Secondary Education has developed a distance learning platform for students of secondary education in Cameroon. A series of lessons taught by qualified teachers for secondary school students. Under the stewardship of Professor Pauline Nalovalyonga in collaboration with the Ministry of Posts and Telecommunications, CAMTEL, CRTV, and UNESCO, we are introducing distance learning as another teaching and learning method which is different from the traditional classroom setting that you are all used to. In the distance education mode, you are not with the teacher in person, so take your time, relax, listen to the teacher, take down notes and visit the following links for any questions or answers to your questions. Take it in your stride. This is Cameroon's solution to COVID-19 and beyond. Professor Nalovalyonga, Minister of Secondary Education.
Welcome back to your distance learning, the place where you have the opportunity to learn from a distance, place. So we are going to continue our lessons. Mr. Bakoto Bayo, your geography teacher. We are going to continue our lessons for geography for the class of Form 1. In the last class, I gave an assignment. About lesson 10. This lesson 10 was about the notion of the environment. So the assignment I gave was to list any three ways by which we can avoid wasting energy. So we can avoid wasting energy by always turn off the light when we go out of a room if nobody is left there. So if you're in a room, you're in the parlor, in your bedroom, if nobody is left in a room when you go out, just turn off the light. Secondly, turn off the television and other equipment when they are not used. At times you see people, they go out of the house, they go in the bedroom, but the TV is still on. So when you're not looking at the TV and not watching the TV, just turn off the TV. Open the windows during the day rather than using the bulbs. If you are using the day, because you know, during the day, you have sunlight, you have the daylight. So to avoid wasting energy, just open the windows and let the light enter, and it is even more beneficial to you. So this thing of avoid wasting energy is a way to protect our natural environment, because we use the resources of the environment to produce energy. Water, we use water to produce electricity. So we should not waste this electricity, because if we waste, we're going to waste also the resources of the natural environment. So we continue our lesson number 10. Lesson 10 today is weather observation. Our lesson shall consist of an analysis of the previous knowledge, what you're supposed to know to better understand this lesson. We are going to examine a real life situation, something you have already seen maybe, or noticed, or even in the TV. And next, we are going to examine the learning objectives, what you are supposed to do at the end of this lesson. We're going to enter into the lesson properly, then I'll give some exercises, then an assignment at the end. So, at the end of this lesson, you should define weather and climate. And in defining weather and climate, you are supposed to bring out the difference between weather and climate. You should identify the elements of weather, to list them. And thirdly, you should match the elements of weather with the associated instrument. We study this element of weather. Which instrument is used to study this element of weather? You are supposed to list them. So imagine this situation. A plane on arriving at an airport to land, is being blown down to crash by a very strong wind. Consequently, 180 people died. What do you think should be done to avoid such a disaster next time? So, let's take back the situation. The plane, on arriving at the airport, wants to land. But before it lands, there's a terrible wind such that the plane is blown down to crash and people lost their life. So, what do you think we should do to avoid such a disaster next time? At the end of this lesson, I'm going to bring back this situation for you to be able to know what you are supposed to do to avoid such a situation next time. So, at the end of this lesson will enable you, learners, to plan day-to-day activities according to the weather elements. To plan the activities like agriculture, like transport, like traveling, depending on the weather elements. So, what is weather? What is climate? Weather is the state of the atmosphere of a place over a short period of time. We say the atmosphere is the envelope of air that surrounds the Earth's surface. So when we move out, and what is just above the Earth's surface on which we are moving, what is just above the Earth's surface, which is made up of gases, it is quite invisible. It's made up of gases, makes up the atmosphere. So weather is the state. How is the atmosphere at a particular moment? How is the atmosphere at 7 a.m.? How is the atmosphere at 10 a.m.? How is the atmosphere at 3 p.m.? So when we ask these questions, is to study how the atmosphere is at a particular moment, at a particular place. How is the atmosphere in Yaoundé at 3 p.m.? That's the state of the atmosphere, which is weather. So, as we are studying the state of the atmosphere at a particular moment, it is because the weather is always changing. The atmosphere, the state of the atmosphere, is never constant. It is always changing. Therefore, weather changes over time. Weather changes from time to time. So now, what is climate? Remember that you are supposed to define weather and climate and differentiate them. Climate is the average atmospheric condition of a place over a long period of time, usually 35 years. So when we study the state of the atmosphere of a particular place for a month, for a year, after we take the average for a long period, usually 35 years, we enter now in the notion of the climate of the place. Like you can have, you record all the temperatures of Yaoundé, all the temperatures of Bétouan. Every day, after you get the average for the week, after you get the average for the month, after you take the average for the year, after you sum for 35 years, you take the average. So now you have the average for 35 years, which is now climate, the climate of. So now, what is weather observation? The title of lesson 10, weather observation. Weather observation is the act of monitoring. Monitoring is observing. Monitoring, observing, recording information about the state of the atmosphere. So you observe and you write down what you observe. That is monitoring and recording information about the state of the atmosphere. How is the state, how is the atmosphere, the particular moment? Observe, then you write down. That is monitoring and recording. Now, when we monitor and when we record, we should also be able to know how the atmosphere will be maybe in 1 day, in 2 days. That is now weather forecast. Weather forecast is an important aspect of weather observation. Imagine a situation where you don't know that that rain is going to fall in the morning. So you don't have an umbrella, you don't have a pullover. And when you are going to school, rain starts falling. Rain falls on you because you are forced to go to school. Are you going to be happy? No. But if there's weather forecast will help you to know that on Tuesday morning, it is going to rain. And if you know that the rain is going to fall on Tuesday morning, you are going to prepare a warm pullover. You are going to prepare the boots and the umbrella even to protect yourself from rain. So weather forecast is an important aspect of weather observation. So we say weather observation is monitoring and recording information about the state of the atmosphere. So measuring weather and climate. How do we measure weather and climate? How do we measure the state of the atmosphere? It is done by using equipment called weather instruments. So let's see some of these instruments and the weather element. Remember that our objective, one of our objectives, is to list the elements of weather and to list the instrument used to measure each element of weather. So as we are going to examine the weather element and the instrument, try to pay attention to how they look like, how the instruments look like. Okay, let's go. First one is the sunshine recorder. The sunshine recorder is used to determine the hours of sunshine for a particular day. You see, this is the instrument, this is the sunshine recorder. You see this ball? This ball is transparent. Transparent means when the sun is shining, you see the sun is shining and it is shown on this part. You see this white spot. It shows where the sun is shining. And this paper in blue is a paper which is burned by the sun rays. See, as the sun is shining on this transparent ball, it is reflected on this paper and it is burning the paper. So at the end of the day, we are going to measure this number of hours of sunshine for the day and we are going to determine the number of hours the sunshine during the day. So that's hours of sunshine. Then sunshine recorder. Now we have the thermometer. I'm sure you have already seen a thermometer. When you are sick, you use a thermometer. When you go to the hospital, they usually put you a thermometer to determine the temperature of the body. Now the thermometer we use in weather observation is now used to determine the temperature, but not the temperature of the body, the temperature of the atmosphere. So we have two types of thermometers. We have the maximum thermometer. Maximum means the highest. Now minimum means the lowest. So the maximum thermometer is used to determine the highest temperature of a given day. And these thermometers are usually used in places where we have very high temperatures. For example, you can ask, what is the highest temperature of this place? We use now the maximum thermometer to determine the maximum temperature, the highest temperature of the place. On the other hand, the minimum thermometer is used to determine the lowest temperature of a given day. What is the lowest temperature of a given place? It can be negative 40, negative 50, negative 30. So this is the representation of a thermometer. Thermometer measures the temperature. Most often it is in degrees Celsius, as you can see the scale here, degrees Celsius. So it shows at the same time the lowest temperature and the highest temperature of the place. So you see, You see the values here. Look at the value 0. You have 10, 20, 30, 40. Look at the values down in black. You have 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So this first side shows the lowest temperature because you have 20 degrees Celsius below zero. That is now negative 20 degrees Celsius. Now this other one, the right side, is showing the temperatures above 20, above zero, I mean, above zero. So what do we have there? This is our zero here. This is our zero. This is our 10. This is our 20. So our temperature there is about 20, 24, 25 degrees Celsius. So the first part, the left part, showing the minimum temperature. Therefore, it is which type of thermometer? The minimum thermometer. Now this other part is showing the highest temperature. Therefore, it is the maximum thermometer. So now we have the barometer. The barometer is used to determine the atmospheric pressure of a given place. Pressure. Pressure is the weight of air. The air is made up of gases. So as it is made up of gases, the gases have their own weight. So as they have their own weight, they exert pressure on the Earth's surface. So atmospheric pressure is that weight of air expressed on a given surface. So we use the barometer to determine that weight of air at a given place. So we have two types of barometer. We have the mercury barometer and the aneroid barometer. This is the mercury barometer to the left, this is the aneroid barometer. So this is how it functions. As atmospheric pressure is the weight of air. If the weight of air increases, you see how it will push this mercury down. We push the mercury down. As you push the mercury down, the mercury will be forced to enter into this tube. As we enter into this tube, the level of the mercury in the tube will increase. So an increase in atmospheric pressure will push the mercury will be forced to enter into this tube, increasing the level of this, the level of the mercury in this tube. So the level of the mercury in that tube determines the atmospheric pressure. So we measure the atmospheric pressure using the mercury barometer. And it is the same thing for this other one, but it is much more sophisticated, much more modern, much more precise. Okay, now we have the wind vane. The wind vane is used to determine the direction from which the wind is blowing. I'm sure you have already seen this thing somewhere, maybe in the TV. I'm sure you have already seen. Even in schools, you have already seen. So it is used to show the direction from which the wind is blowing. So this arrow, as the wind is blowing, the wind will turn the arrow, because that arrow is the type of arrow that can turn, that can turn. So as the wind is blowing, the wind will turn the arrow in the direction from which it is blowing. And therefore, we are going to say that the wind is blowing from the west, or the wind is blowing from the north, from the south, or from the east. So we determine the direction of the wind using the wind vane. Now we have the anemometer. The anemometer is used to determine the speed of wind. As the wind is blowing, you see these parts. They are cups. So when the wind is blowing, it enters into the holes. You force it to turn. You force it to turn. So now, if the wind is very strong, it will force those things to turn very fast. And now, how can we determine the number of turns this thing is having? Look at the figure here. So we are going to determine the number of turns, maybe for a period of 1 minute. So you can have maybe 10 turns per minute, 60 turns per minute, 100 turns per minute, depending on the energy of the wind. The stronger the wind, the higher the number of turns. And the number of turns will be measured using this instrument. You see here, it is 28.3 turns. So you can imagine the energy that the wind is having. So there it is, 28.3 kilometers per hour. So the energy of the wind determine the speed. Wind speed will force this thing to turn, and therefore it will be measured and converted into kilometers per hour. Now we have the hygrometer. The hygrometer is used to determine the amount of water present in air. There's a moment you feel as if there is a lot of water in the air. The air is moist. So we use this hygrometer to determine the amount of water present in the air. Now we have the rain gauge. We see the rain. The rain is one of the weather elements that we can see, regularly. So we use the rain gauge to determine the amount of rainfall of a given place at a given time. So you see, the rain gauge is a container. So as the rain is falling, it will enter through this part. Which is the funnel. It will enter into the funnel, then it will enter into the collecting cylinder, collecting tube. And you see that on this collecting tube, it is like a ruler. It is graduated into millimeters. So the millimeters is used to measure the amount of rainfall that occurred at a given place and at a given time. So if a lot of water, if there's a lot of rain, you will notice that this tube will be full. But if the rain falls just for a few minutes, you see that just a small amount of water will be collected into the tube. So the amount of water that falls through rainfall in a particular place is measured using a rain gauge. The rain gauge, which is a container which has a funnel on the top, and then a tube which is graduated in millimeter. So which unit do we use? Do we use to measure the amount of rainfall? We use the millimeters. Just like the temperatures, we generally use the degree Celsius. Now we use the millimeters. So, as a summary, weather elements and their instrument. Our objective, I recall the objective, we should be able to list the weather element, should be able to list or to match the weather elements and their instrument. So to measure precipitation or rainfall, we use the rain gauge. To measure humidity, we use the hygrometer. We said humidity refers to the amount of water which is found in the atmosphere. How moist is the atmosphere? We use the hygrometer. Now we equally have cloud cover. Cloud cover is simply refers to the amount of clouds that we have in the atmosphere. And we know that when there is a lot of clouds, you cannot even see the sun. The sky is simply dark. So the cloud cover, what do we use? Simply the eye, you simply observe. If the sky is completely covered, you can notice that with the eye. If it is completely covered, you cannot see, the sun. So now the temperature is measured using the thermometer. We saw there are two types, the maximum to measure the highest temperature of the day, and a minimum to measure the lowest temperature of the day. It is usually measured in degree Celsius. We have a sunshine recorder. Sunshine measured by the sunshine recorder. We have pressure, atmospheric pressure measured by the barometer. We have the wind direction, which is measured by the wind vane. The wind speed measured by the anemometer. So, importance of weather observation. It is important to farmers. It is important for aircraft. Aircraft use needs to be aware of the prevailing weather conditions to land. Now, thirdly, the type of clothes people wear in different parts of the world is influenced by weather. So, we said weather is important to farmers. Farmers need water. The rainfall influences agriculture, farming. So, farming is usually done during the rainy season. And how do we determine the rainy season? We observe rainfall for a long period of time to know that at this month of the year, at the month of September, for example, we are going to have rain. At the month of January, we are not going to have rain, for example. We observe that over the years for a long period of time to know that at this moment we have the rainy season. So now, secondly, the aircraft need to be aware of the prevailing weather condition. The planes need to be aware of the energy of the wind. If there is strong wind, what is the direction of the wind? Can we land there safely? And so on and so forth. So now, the type of clothes people wear in different parts of the world is influenced by weather. So the temperature, if you are in a place where there is a lot of heat, like in the desert, you are supposed to wear light dresses, like the color even white. But if you are in a cold place, you are supposed to wear thick pullovers. So you see that when we study the weather elements, we are able to plan our daily activities. When do we carry out farming? When should we travel? Which type of dresses should we wear? Which type of food should we expect in the market? There are some food that prefer certain seasons. So when we observe that, we are able to determine that at this period of the year, we are going to have corn, we are going to have pear, we are going to have pineapples, oranges, and so on. So exercises, define weather. Weather is the atmospheric condition of the place at a particular time. Say the state of the atmosphere at a particular time. So match the following weather elements to their corresponding weather instrument. We have rainfall, wind direction, wind speed, temperature, humidity, pressure, cloud cover, thermometer, rain gauge, anemometer, wind vane, barometer, hygrometer, and the ice. So you match. So this is what we are supposed to do. Rainfall is measured using the rain gauge. Wind direction is measured using the wind vane. Wind speed is measured using the anemometer. Temperature using the thermometer. Humidity using the hygrometer. Pressure using the barometer. Cloud cover using the ice. So the situation at the beginning of the lesson was that a plane on arriving at an airport to land is being blown down to crash by a very strong wind. Consequently, 180 people died. And the question was, what do you think should be done to avoid such a disaster next time? So we should study the weather elements at the airport, particularly wind direction and wind speed, to know if the airport is safe for landing. So now, assignment. What happens to rainwater when it reaches the Earth's surface? So to produce this lesson, these are the references consulted. We have Aqua Constance, and all Interactive Physical Geography for Ordinary Level. We have Chandi, the R, 2018, 21st Century Applied Physical Geography and Map Book, you have Jabe Roland Wele, an illustrated physical geography and map reading for Cameroon GC ordinary level. So our next lesson shall be on the streams and rivers of Cameroon.
Unatege si matege yop, unatege minga matege nyom, unatege majang matege ndom, manetambia ninya ne njubia yen, ngani bana matege mot, ngani lakiri watege ndong, esekina bia dinkido, manetambia ninya ne njubia yen, tamtama mote tamzabike, Tam tama tonge tam zabike tam tam tama mote tam zabike manetambia ninyane njubia yen